Welcome to another edition of Breaking News. I'm your host, anybody but Trump. Green coffee. Can y'all believe this white lady got on TV talking about I'm protesting the wearing of masks because, like George Floyd, I can't breathe? I was about to say this. How dare she? It just goes to show how much of America just doesn't understand the black experience. They don't understand what it means to be black and brown or a minority in the United States of America. Ha, she talking about she can't breathe. Heffa, you were born breathing. The rest of us was born with a noose around our neck, and we just trying to survive. So how was it in Louisville that as they were getting ready to make that final verdict in regards to the Breonna Taylor case, that they started locking down the city, knowing full well that the verdict was not going to be in the favor of Breonna Taylor? The verdict was, the cop got in more trouble for almost shooting a dog in a neighbor's house than for shooting Breonna Taylor, an innocent black woman who was sleeping in her own apartment. So yes, protests around the nation continue as people protest for black lives. Black lives do matter. And we know the stakes are up and high in Louisville this week. They about to burn that sucker down to the ground. This week, Ruth Bader Ginsburg was laid to rest. 2020, just taken away from us as much as it possibly can. Ruth Ginsburg is known for being a woman of power. She served her country, she lifted up the needs of women in America, and she lived her life to uplift those who were downtrodden. I don't know, she was trying to hang in there until the November election, but 2020 was like, it ain't happening. It just took her away. Now we in a situation where Mr. Donald Trump, he trying to make sure he put somebody in her place before he gets booted out. Because that sucker, that orange glob of insecurities, he know. Ain't nobody want him in there. He know he unpopular. He know he dumb as a bunch of rocks. But still, he pushing forward. That man going to try and steal the country. And he trying to steal it right now by trying to replace Ginsburg before the election is over. Our main story tonight is election season is upon us. Y'all need to go out and make sure you register to vote. You only got a few more days to register. If you're talking about Black Lives Matter, you need to make sure you register to vote. You're talking about Black Lives Matter, you need to make sure you either show up to vote or you get everything in place so that you can vote. You better vote. Don't be talking about no Black Lives Matter unless you take your black self out there and vote. Y'all make sure you check the link below so you can find out what you need to do to make sure you can vote in this November election. This may be the last week for you to register, so make sure you register. So the question is, who are you gonna vote for? It's okay, you got a few weeks to figure it out. There are only two choices. I don't know what this thing is with American only two choices. They make you want to think you got a choice, but you ain't got no choice. It's one or the other. Neither of them are even on your side. They're just pretending. So you got to vote for the lesser evil, the one that's less evil for you. And as far as I'm concerned, it ain't Donald Trump. So I'm telling everybody to vote for anybody but Trump. And in this case, that just happens to be Joe Biden. Joe Biden ain't gonna do nothing for us, but guess what? He ain't Trump. So make sure you get ready and that you can vote against Trump. Anybody but Trump. That's what I'm telling you. You need to vote anybody but Trump. I know a lot of people are out there talking about they're gonna vote for Trump because he represents Christianity. My question for you is, which Jesus does he represent? Does he represent the Jesus of the Bible? Does he represent the Jesus of the Spanish Inquisition? Does he represent the Jesus that promoted slavery in America? Oh, he represents white Jesus, right? The one for white superiority? The one that is willing to hold up a Confederate flag talking about, this represents my history. Mofo, that represents a short-lived country that tried to separate itself from the Union. It don't represent no America. So if y'all gonna vote, I'm telling you that you need to be like me and vote for anybody but Trump.